character, right?
See how you. So, Mikey, tell me about Quentin Tarantino. Why do you like him? What are some of your favorite films?
We're talking about films.
Yeah.
And first, we start talking about boxing films. I told him one of my favorite movies is Cinderella Man.
It was a great movie.
The Fighter.
That was Mark Wahlberg is a big fan of yours, by the way.
He's a fan.
Mikey, when are you coming back?
Mark, what's up?
To your fight, January 28th.
Yeah, if you can make it, that'd be great. You know, I like those, you know, true story movies like that. I haven't seen Vinny Paz's movie. I haven't seen
Bleed for This.
So I haven't seen
Vinny Paz is funny.
I'm sure it's
I hung
good.
Out with him in Miami.
Oh, yeah?
He's funny.
I met him at the show the other day. I saw Hands of Stone. Pretty good movie. Not like my favorite, like Cinderella Man or...
How can Usher play a fighter, though?
I don't like it.
But it was good. It was good.
You don't like boxing movies?
I don't watch the Rocky movie. I've seen it.
You must be the only fighter on the planet to have not watched Rocky.
I never said I should watch the entire film. I've seen bits here and there, and I'll end up changing it. I just don't like it. It's too fake. But I can see why people like it, because it's the Cinderella story. People love the underdog making it to the top. The hustle, the hard times. You know, they love that.
Hey, you got a statue and the Hall of Fame out of it. Yeah. So
they love that. But it's not what I enjoy. But other movies that I really like, we mentioned the Quentin Tarantino films. I love them.
His movies are very gory, very like killing,
very crazy out
right?
there. But he's a genius. He's a genius at what he does. Because others can try to do something like that,
he couldn't
pull
it off.
They can't pull it off, and he does it.
He's done some acting too.
Yeah, he's
Django Unchained. I named my son Django for that reason. Alexandros Django, because it's just a beautiful movie. Great movie.
Jamie Foxx is a big boxing fan too.
It's huge. No, we were. What movie was that? He was in front of us, I think.
Madonna fight.
Did you talk to him at all?
Just say hi. I didn't take a picture.
Allie, if Quentin Tarantino was to write a boxing, like crazy style movie and had Mikey star in it, it'd push him over the top.
And who would play Frank in the movie?
Not about a life story. I'm talking about like a Pulp Fiction kind of boxing
Pulp
movie.
Pulp Fiction has some boxing.
I've never seen Pulp Fiction.
No!
Oh, you gotta watch it.
Shaq
would always make fun of me. I'm gonna rub your feet. I take your mama to rub my feet. Because it's from that movie.
Throw you off the balcony, throw off the fourth.
Whenever I tell people, I get the same reaction that Mike just did.
What? You've never seen it?
You should watch it then. Oh, you like that reaction. So you tell him that.
No, I've never seen it.
It's bad.
So wait, which actor could play Frank? Do you have one in Hollywood that could pull him off?
Quentin
Tarantino would write not about Mike's life story, about a crazy thing like Pulp Fiction, man. He could think of something.
What's Pulp Fiction about?
It's like three different stories,
but they all have something in common. It's a gangster film with boxing fixing.
He did Django.
He did Magnificent Seven, was it? Was it?
I don't know. You can look it up. It's the internet.
This last one with Denzel?
No, that's Seven. The one before that.
Oh.
Something else. Or something.
I didn't see that.
The Hateful Eight.
What, you saw that?
Yeah.
It's good?
Yeah. Hateful Eight.
What about Kill Bill?
Kill Bill is crazy.
One and two.
Yeah.
He did a lot of them.
You gotta watch that.
He's done a lot.
I don't think I've ever seen any of his movies except for Django.
Bad.
Uma Thurman looks so sexy in that movie too.
And which one?
You're a religious guy. Religious people don't talk like that, Frank.
What? Why can't
Mikey? Religious people should be more humble and not talk about
that. God made women. Women are beautiful.
Right, but you don't say sexy. You got to be more respectful. You're religious now.
Yeah.
Now religious people.
Now, if she was here in front of me, okay, I could see your point. But she is.
That's right, Frank.
Religious people do not.
You don't think Uma Thurman? You know, just because she's not like everybody else's woman, like big busted, big butt, she's still sexy because of the character.
You know what Uma means in German?
No.
Grandma.
Oh, I don't know that.
I'm just telling you. Uma. Upa is grandpa.
Oh, yeah? Upa?
Upa.
So, Uma. Grandma.
Huh. So, what were we saying? So,
just get Quentin Tarantino to write Mikey a story.
Django. Unchained.
You don't even have to pay Mikey to play in it. We'll do it for free.
Have you ever seen a sequel that was better than the original Mikey in movies? The sequels 99% of the time fail.
Never. Hold on. Let me see. A sequel that was better than the first.
American Pie 2.
the first one was classic.
But the second one was still good.
The second one was at the beach with the lesbians. That one was very good.
Those lesbians were pretty.
Oh, I know.
Hey,
it
earmuffs. Earmuffs.
Ip Man too. What about Ip Man? Ip Man.
Ip Man?
Yeah, IP Man. Bruce Lee's trainer. Donnie Yen.
Never seen that.
Rush Hour 3 was the worst movie ever made, and I'm sorry if they watch my videos, but that was a pretty bad movie.
Rush Hour 1 was fucking bad.
1 was the best. 2 was okay.
2 was good.
3rd one was like they
just... Friday was good.
I've never seen
Friday movies. Next Friday was also good, but not as quite as good as the first.
Friday After Next.
They're good, but not.
I've never seen the Friday movies either.
No, you gotta watch it. It's a classic.
Dude, what the fuck?
You gotta watch
Empire Strikes Back. That was a good part too.
No.
Star Wars?
No.
Never seen a Star Wars.
Never seen a Star Wars movie.
Frank, your taste in movies is pretty bad.
Taste in women also. He showed me some women that he thinks they're cute.
Security check.
Not quite there.
But I mean, whatever.
I showed him some chick on Instagram yesterday. He's like,
I like pointy chin.
What's up with that?
She has a pointy chin.
What the fuck, Frank? She's probably like a 9, dude.
He's rejecting her.
She got a pointy chin.
Don't fucking act like you wouldn't fucking want to have her here next to you right now, Frank.
She has a pointy chin, man.
Read the caption.
So what? Yeah, sure. Has there ever been a sequel that was better than the first?
I don't think so. No, I think usually sequels and then your remakes are just as bad. Karate Kid,
you know,
is a
which
classic.
One really good? Godfather.
Oh yeah, Godfather 2.
Godfather 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah. Three.
Because the way they did it, it's almost like it's all one piece.
I didn't want to tell you that I've never seen a Godfather movie.
That's fine. Yeah.
You should watch it. They're pretty good.
Godfather, it's like it's not like it was one and then
the
two
video,
and then
all
three.
The videos, oh, that's tight.
It's almost like if it was all one combined over the generation, you know, the lifespan of the family, the life. So it's not like it was 1, 2, and 3. It's almost like it was all built
in
one.
Does your taste in movies change as you grow older or no?
Yeah, when you're a kid, you like some cheesier things.
Yeah.
Now it's different. Also, your perspective on life changes after you're a father, after you have kids, and
but you
married.
Said that how you saw movies.
I told the one moment that I saw it that it kind of triggered it for me, where I kind of realized, holy shit, it's on another level now. Crash. I had seen Crash.
Yep.
It's a 2004, 2006
movie. Right.
I had seen it.
And it went over your head the first time. You didn't pay attention to it.
It was a good movie, but not like that impact. But then after I had my daughter, and I watched it again. And it gave me a different perspective. That little scene when Michael Peña is outside and the guy from the store is holding the gun and the little daughter runs to him, hugs him, and the guy shoots the gun.
Yep.
It's a blank, but he doesn't.
Yeah.
But the reaction, the way the father just holds the daughter and screams.
Yeah.
And, you know, that moment there, it watered my eyes. It was like, holy shit, because it made me fucking kind of
relate
in that situation, relate to that. That's great directing. That's great fucking acting. That took me to another level. Now that you have kids, it has a different perspective.
Yeah. It's like Training Day.
Many times
I find myself in a situation playing cards with cholos.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, man, this might not end good. But everybody's cool. Everybody's very supportive. But
see, it's this perspective.
That's a great movie.
So life experiences do give you another side of, you know, that maybe a movie you before didn't impact you a certain way. Maybe it didn't bring out certain emotions. And now it does.
Videos you post.
Thank you.